This unassuming piece of electronic is the Beecore version 2, a replacement all-in-one flight board for quadcopters with a blade inductrix or tiny whoop style design. Its main advantage is its F3 flight controller with the popular Betaflight firmware, allowing it to configure things like flight modes and characteristics not otherwise possible on the inductrix or most of its clones. The original Beecore was launched in 2016, but recently the manufacturer released a second version with OSD support. In the context of FPV, OSD, or on-screen display, means the ability to layer useful information from the flight controller over the FPV feed. This is achieved by intercepting the video signal between camera and transmitter and piping it through the flight controller. Because of this, you also need to use either a separate camera and video transmitter or an all-in-one module with OSD support. This is something I've been wanting to test out, so I decided to combine the Beecore V2 with probably my favorite tiny whoop-style quadcopter, the Eachine E011. This build, if you can call it that, would also feature an all-in-one FPV module of the brand Turbo Wing, which seems to be one of the cheaper OSD-compatible micro-solutions currently available. The total, excluding a compatible transmitter, which I already own, came to around $60. A pretty good deal, provided of course it all works in the end. Welcome to this mini review slash brief tutorial slash video of the Beecore V2 slash board of the Beecore version 2 flight board. The first step, as always, involves taking things apart until you aren't quite sure you'll be able to put them back together again. In this particular case, it's the E011 which needs to have its flight board removed in order to make room for the Beecore replacement. If you're following along at home, take care not to yank the motor cables out from their connectors or the sockets out from the board when disconnecting the motors. Next, let's get the soldering out of the way. There's a total of 6 solder points, 4 for connecting the camera, and 2 for attaching one of several provided battery pigtails. There seems to be some confusion regarding the labeling of the video in and video out through holes, so if you don't get picture on the first attempt, just try reversing these. Now let's attach the Beecore to the frame. When I held the board in place, I noticed the micro USB port was partly obscured, so I took away a bit of the frame with a Dremel tool before mounting the board. Otherwise, the motors plug in the same way as before. The Beecore comes with some screws and rubber spaces you can use if you want. Okay, time to apply the final touches and boot up Betaflight Configurator. The board comes with version 3.2 partly configured, so I really only had to set up some way to arm it and switch flight modes, adjust the on-screen display to my liking, and, oh, in case it helps anyone, increase the motor PVM speed parameter, which for some reason kept my build from being able to take off. All in all, I estimate the whole process took a little over an hour. And we got liftoff! After a bit of the aforementioned tweaking, my Beecore Enhanced E011 flies well, and because this is Betaflight, the experience is completely customizable. Unfortunately though, I don't quite get neither the same power nor flight time as with the stock board. I guess because the Beecore itself is more power hungry. Flights last only around 3 minutes, so it feels a lot like going back to an original inductrix-based tiny whoop. As you can see, the OSD is working, showing various useful flight data, from flight time to received signal strength. You'll see a couple of different variations throughout the video. After disarming, you even get this neat summary of your flight. Via the OSD, you can also access a very basic looking, but surprisingly deep menu, making it possible to adjust a lot of Betaflight's parameters right there in the field. As you can maybe tell, the battery voltage indicator doesn't seem to give an accurate reading. At first, I just thought this was because the onboard sensor circuitry was defective or wrongly calibrated, but then I learned this could actually be an accurate reading of when you try to draw a higher current from a battery than it's able to provide, so-called voltage sag. I may just need to go shopping for a higher discharge rated battery. All in all, the Beecore V2 is pretty impressive considering its size and price, but I want to stress it shouldn't be thought of as practically ready to go with just some assembly required. Getting up and running can be a real, if fun, exercise. For the best experience, I think you should expect a bit of a challenge and be prepared for, or even enjoy, some troubleshooting. As long as you are, I think you'll find the Beecore V2 a fun bite-sized hobby project. As for my particular build, several things seem to indicate that the E011's stock battery doesn't quite have enough punch to comfortably power both board, motors, and the FPV module I chose to go with. If you're deciding on the parts for your own build, I recommend either choosing a different model to base it off, or at least getting one of Eachine's upgraded 45C batteries, as I will do. Hey there, and thanks for watching this not quite review and not quite tutorial thing. Also, sorry for the long hiatus, I'll try to deliver the next video in a more timely fashion. See you in the next review, bye!